weird things happen on the baseball field.
The story actually started in Detroit.
Ball players never forget.
It's part of the game.
That's how it ended sometimes.
Back in the early 80s, Don McMahon, who was my pitching coach at Anaheim, he would always catch me between starts. He was my pitching coach in Cleveland. And Mac had a unique way of catching us pitchers between starts. He would actually sit almost on top of home plate, almost like Tony Pena does when he gets real low, or Benito Santiago. He'll just sit there, and so you're throwing to him and stuff like that. We didn't have a very good ball club. There's a ground crew guy that seemed to always get on us. I don't remember his name, but, you know, he just agitated people. You know, he'd say, "You guys stink. You know, how are you guys even here?" and all this stuff. Well, he's down, I'm throwing on the side down my bullpen, and he's down there raking some sunflower seeds or whatever. He's working on the bullpen area. And I saw him, you know, and he wasn't well-liked by a lot of us with Cleveland. So I thought, you know, I got to work on my fastball in. And I asked him, I said, "Hey, would you do me a favor? Would you maybe just stand up there with your rake, you know, and I'm just kind of, just, I need a batter up there." And Mac's starting, he knows what I'm going to do, Don McMahon. So sure enough, this guy, yeah, well, hello, he stands up there with his rake, and he knows nobody likes him, so do I do. I drill him right in the ribs the first pitch. He goes down, almost starts crying. I felt bad, and I said, "Mac, we're done." And we left and left him there laying.